On January 12, 2018, an Indian rocket took off en route to space, carrying a cluster of 31 satellites into orbit. It was a successful mission, every probe deployed where it needed to be. The only problem? Four of those satellites didn't have permission to fly. The company that made them went rogue. And it's unclear how the US government is going to handle this situation. More and more aerospace companies are launching satellites into space, and the hardware they're sending up is only getting smaller. It really got started with the invention of the CubeSat, a standardized box satellite that manufacturers can stack together, making their own unique probes. And thanks to commercial smartphones, miniature electronics have become widely available at lower costs, which is great news for tiny satellites. But is there such a thing as a satellite that's too small? After all, we need to track these objects in space, and a minuscule device is harder to see from Earth, making it potentially hazardous in low Earth orbit. Charity Whedon, the president and co-founder of space consulting firm Equinox, explained that the US Department of Defense is tracking everything they possibly can with an array of telescopes here on Earth.
They're tracking approximately 20,000 objects in space today. However, there are at least 500,000 smaller objects between 1 centimeter and 10 centimeters that are difficult to track or impossible to track. And then millions beyond that below the 1 centimeter number.
Any one of those millions of objects could cause a big problem. All of those pieces of debris are moving through space at more than 17,000 miles per hour.
So it would take something on the order of a millimeter or two to create possibly damage to a satellite.
If a company wants to launch a satellite safely and legally, they have a lot of government hurdles to clear. There's paperwork to file with the FCC, the FAA, and depending on what your satellite does, you might need to loop in NOAA. The red tape can pile up, but it's largely there to keep Earth's orbit safe and to keep America's interests intact. To get a sense for what this paperwork actually feels like, we visited Spire, a satellite operator based in San Francisco. They've got around 60 small probes in orbit that track ships and weather. We asked them what it takes to convince the government that their satellites are safe and not a threat to anyone else's hardware.
Part of it is you file what your orbit is, you file the size of your spacecraft, and you get approval on all of these things. You run a space debris analysis report, and you submit that along as well, which gets reviewed. There's always the odd occurrence of what they call a conjunction, where two satellites kind of enter the same region, and then they issue alerts, and either if one of the satellites has propulsion, they have the ability to kind of move out of the way. Mm-hmm. But it basically just comes down to a lot of prep ahead of time.
The risk of a collision was a concern for the FCC when it reviewed an application for the company's Swarm Technologies. Based in Silicon Valley, Swarm wants to launch up to 100 satellites that can provide internet connectivity from space. And the company was eager to launch its first 4 satellites, tiny probes smaller than a standardized CubeSat. Those satellites were called the Space Bees. Ultimately, the FCC said no to Swarm because they thought the satellites were too small and too hard to track by the Defense Department.
3, 2, 1, 0, +1, +2, +3, +4.
Despite the denial, Swarm launched its Space Bees anyway. It was the first time in history such an unauthorized launch had happened. The FCC opened an investigation, which is still ongoing. We asked Nick about the situation, and he didn't really want to get into it.
You kind of go through a lot of emotions, mm-hmm. Because we're a company that's always, we try and do things the right way. You don't ever want to be associated with something that, you feel like, did your industry a little bit of a disservice, so.
This all explains why that huge pile of regulations is needed in the first place. Swarm is one of dozens of startups and aerospace companies proposing to send large constellations of satellites into orbit. And that's going to make the low Earth orbit environment a super congested place. In fact, NASA says that once these satellites go up, 99% of them will need to be taken out of orbit within 5 years. Otherwise, the risk of in-space collisions will go up. And this happened once in 2009 when a US commercial communication probe collided with a defunct Russian satellite. And in 2007, China launched a missile at one of its own satellites to show that it could take out a probe in orbit. It was successful, and it made a colossal mess.
There were thousands of pieces that were shed and created essentially a ring around Earth of debris.
The worst case scenario here is something known as the Kessler syndrome.
The Kessler syndrome is a scenario whereby an object collides with another object in space and they beget thousands of pieces of debris, and each piece of those debris are now a danger to another satellite, and so on it goes, and collision begets collision begets collision, and suddenly you're at a point where that orbit is no longer usable at all.
And rogue satellite operators could increase this risk. After the incident, Swarm's CEO expressed remorse and called the incident a mistake. Since then, Swarm has tried to make amends, and the FCC even granted the company a new license to launch an upcoming trio of satellites on a SpaceX mission. It's unclear if the scandal will change the course of regulations for the satellite industry, though. In the meantime, the Trump administration is actively looking at ways to streamline regulations for satellites. Whatever happens, it's clear that we need to be good custodians of space. That way, we can all use it in the future.
It behooves everyone to worry about this issue, to have that fundamental space situation awareness, to have those best practices in play, but we really can't afford another collision in space.
Hey everyone, thanks so much for watching our video. If you want more science content like this, be sure to check out our Verge Science YouTube channel. I'll see you there.